Shalom, Israel. I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh and His mighty Son, Yahweh Bahashem Hamashiach Yahawashah. Today's lesson, God does not love everybody. For God so loved the world, which is true. Let's get that. John 3:16.
The book of John, chapter 3, verse 16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
But now we need to find out who the world is and whosoever is. Most people think that world means the entire earth and all the inhabitants on the earth. World means nation, and whosoever is speaking to that nation. Let's find out. Isaiah chapter 45 verse 17, read.
The book of Isaiah chapter 45 verse 17, but Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation. He shall not be ashamed nor confounded, world without end.
Right here it's saying world without end. Now who is that world? But Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation. Now let's find out about whosoever. Let's go to the book of Acts chapter 2 verse 21 and 22. Read.
The book of Acts chapter 2 verse 21. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
So let's find out who the whosoever is. Read.
Ye men of Israel.
Stop. Ye men of Israel is the whosoever. Read.
Hear these words, Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God among you by miracles and wonders and signs which God did by him in the midst of you, as ye yourselves also know.
So right here, we understand now who the whosoever is. If you're not clear, let's find out what Yahawasha has to say, Jesus.
The book of Matthew chapter 15 verse 24, and but he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
I am not sent but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. It didn't say everybody. It said the house of Israel. That takes us to Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 8. Read.
The book of Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 8. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace.
You see, everyone says that God loves everybody, all you Christians say. And right here, God is saying there's a time to hate. There's a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. That takes us to Exodus chapter 15, verse 3. Read.
The book of Exodus chapter 15, verse 3. The Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name.
The Lord is a man of war. Now in war, there's killing and bloodshed. That takes me to the book of Psalm chapter 101 verse 3. Read.
The book of Psalm chapter 101 verse 3. I will set no wicked thing before mine eyes. I hate the work of them that turn aside. It shall not cleave to me.
Right here he says, I hate the work of them that turn aside. So if you're a sinner, you're wicked. He says, I hate the work of them that turn aside. But I thought the Lord loved everybody. That takes us back to the book of Matthew chapter 15 verse 24. Read.
The book of Matthew chapter 15 verse 24. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
So I'm seeing clearly who he loved. Only the house of Israel. Let's go to the book of Ecclesiasticus chapter 25 verse 2. If you're not still clear about the fact that God doesn't love everybody, read.
The book of Ecclesiasticus chapter 25 verse 2. Three sorts of men my soul hateth, and I am greatly offended at their life. A poor man that is proud, a rich man that is a liar, and an old adulterer that doteth.
A poor man, he calls Israel poor. A rich man that is a liar and an old adulterer, some cheater, a doter. And that right there, folks, takes us right back to Matthew chapter 15, verse 24. Read.
The book of Matthew chapter 15, verse 24. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
So for you people who love to bring out John 3:16, for God so loved the world, right here, these are the precepts to help educate you. Negroes, that the world is talking about you, the Negroes that are the house of Israel. That right there brings us to Romans chapter 9, verse 13.
The book of Romans, chapter 9, verse 13. As it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated.
But I thought God loved everybody. Once again, the Bible's correct and you're wrong. That brings us to the book of Malachi, chapter 1, verse 1. Read.
The book of Malachi, chapter 1, verse 1. The burden of the word of the Lord to Israel by Malachi, I have loved you, saith the Lord. Yet ye say, wherein hast thou loved us? Was not Esau Jacob's brother, saith the Lord? Yet I loved Jacob, and I hated Esau, and laid his mountains and his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness.
So right here, the Lord is telling you that he loved Jacob. That's you, Negroes, that are from the house of Israel. You, the Lord said that he loved, and I hated Esau.
Verse 4, whereas Edom saith, we are impoverished, but we will return and build the desolate places. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, they shall build, but I will throw down, and they shall call them the border of wickedness, and the people against whom the Lord hath indignation forever.
He's talking about Edom right here, folks. The Lord have indignation forever. That's forever. Indignation means hatred. He has hatred forever. So once again, the Bible's correct and you're wrong. That takes us to the book of Joel, chapter 3, verse 19. Read.
The book of Joel, chapter 3, verse 19. Egypt shall be a desolation, and Edom shall be a desolate wilderness for the violence against the children of Judah, because they have shed innocent blood in their land.
So why did he talk about all this destruction that's going to be happening to Egypt and Edom? Because these are the ones that put us in slavery. So the Lord's going to get his vengeance upon you. That takes us to Ezekiel 25:14. Read.
The book of Ezekiel, chapter 25, verse 14. And I will lay my vengeance upon Edom by the hand of my people Israel, and they shall do in Edom according to mine anger and according to my fury, and they shall know my vengeance, saith the Lord God.
The children of Israel, the hand of my people Israel. It's the children of Israel that's going to be laying waste to Edom. And for you individuals that feel like you don't have it in you to do, don't worry about it, because the Lord said his anger will be your anger. His vengeance will be within you. So it doesn't matter what you ain't into. You're going to do so, saith the Lord. That takes us to Psalm 83, verse 1, because we want to find out what the Lord's hit list is. Read.
The book of Psalm, chapter 83, verse 1. Keep not thou silence, O God, hold not thy peace, and be not still, O God, for lo, thine enemies make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people, and consulted against thy hidden ones. They have said, come, and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance.
The hidden ones is the house of Israel. And what did the crafty council do? They put us in slavery. They took away our nation. They took away our language. They took away our culture. And then they took our identity and said, we were going to make them a nation no more. No more. We'll be no more in remembrance. We won't remember who we are. And we don't today. Verse 5, read.
Verse 5. For they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee, the tabernacles of Edom and the Ishmaelites and of...
Now we're getting into the hit list. This is the hit list. For everyone who says that God loves everybody, let's read the hit list of everybody that he doesn't love. Read.
The tabernacles of Edom and the Ishmaelites of Moab and the Hagarim. Verse 7, Ebal and... Ammon and Amalek, the Philistines with the inhabitants of Tyre, Ashur also is joined with them. They have Hopen, the children of Lot, Selah. Do unto them as unto the Midianites, as to Sisera, and as to Jabin, at the brook of Kishon.
Read.
Verse 16, fill their faces with shame, that they may seek thy name, O Lord. Let them be confounded and troubled forever. Yea, let them be put to shame and perish, that men may know that thou, whose name alone is Jehovah, art thou art the Most High over all the earth.
Now, that sounds like a lot of death and destruction. That don't sound like a whole lot of love. Because he loved everybody. For God to love the world. Once again, that brings us back to Matthew chapter 15, verse 24. Read.
The book of Matthew chapter 15, verse 24. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
So is it clear that who he so loved? The house of Israel. That takes us now to Deuteronomy chapter 23, verse 3. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 23, verse 3. An Ammonite or Moabite shall not enter into the congregation of the Lord, even to their 10th generation shall they not enter into the congregation of the Lord forever.
Forever shall you not enter into the congregation. But I thought he loved everybody. What happened to that? Let's go to Exodus 17, 16. Read.
The book of Exodus chapter 17, verse 16. For he said, because the Lord hath sworn that the Lord will have war with Amalek from generation to generation.
Amalek are the Ashkenazi, Khazarian, Jewish population. And the Lord said that he will have war from generation to generation. Where's all that love at? Let's go to Luke chapter 14, verse 26. Read.
The book of Luke chapter 14, verse 26. If any man come to me and hate not his father and his and mother and wife and children and brethren and sisters, yea, and his own life also, he cannot be my disciple.
Right here, the Lord is telling you, if anything's coming before me, if you don't love me and love me only, he says, if any man come to me and hate not his father and mother, and wife and children and brethren and sisters, yea, and his own life also, he cannot be my disciple. He wants you to hate your life in this world, not love your life in this world. He said, if you love your life in this world, you will lose it. That takes us all the way back to Romans chapter 9, verse 13. Read.
The book of Romans chapter 9, verse 13. As it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated.
Jacob have I loved. Jacob, the offspring of Jacob, the 12 tribes of Israel, all you Negroes that are from Israel. He said, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated. Let's go to 1 John chapter 3, verse 4. Read.
The book of 1 John chapter 3, verse 4. Whosoever committeth sin transgresseth also the law, for sin is the transgression of the law.
If you will love the Lord, you're going to keep his commandments. As a matter of fact, he says it in John 14, 15. Read.
The book of John chapter 14, verse 15. If ye love me, keep my commandments.
He says, if ye love me, keep my commandments. So if you don't keep his commandments, then you're transgressing the law, which means you're a sinner. And I got bad news for you. You know, for all you people that say, God loves everybody. Well, guess what? Give me Ecclesiasticus 12, 6. Read.
The book of Ecclesiasticus chapter 12, verse 6. For the Most High hateth sinners and will repay vengeance unto the ungodly and keepeth them against the mighty day of their punishment.
So a lot of you feel like he hates the sin, but not the sinner. Does that even make sense? People, when you say that, from now on, I want you to look in the mirror and imagine being a donkey face and going hee-haw. Because you're a hee-haw. You're dumb as an ass. The Lord says, for the Most High hateth sinners. So there's no excuse, folks. Today we have proven that the Lord does not love everybody. And with that, shalom.
Shalom.